Hello, I'm Charles Fisher of FishDeck.com, and let's take a look at the inadvertent midline zone read against Nichols. As most of you know, the Pac-12 took away the ability to use live footage, so we'll do a short video using screenshots. Now, it's not as good as what the conference or ESPN can produce, but as all of you know, I'm not a former coach or player, just a fan who wants to learn and pass it along. This will be good enough to achieve that. Defensive analyst for FishDuck.com, Sean Goodbody, pointed out how the inside linebackers are an area for us to watch, and he liked the play on the defensive line. Note how the linebackers are getting caught up in the wash of blocking and not always filling the gap. The secondary tackles superbly in open field, but there's too many 6 to 8 yard runs getting through our inside linebackers, and it's something to watch next week against better competition in a good Virginia team. I was impressed with this tight end blocking the linebacker and how long he sustained the block to free up a big run. It's number 83, Johnny Munt, and it's no wonder he's on the field as a true freshman. Guys, keep your eyes on me as I have a quick announcement to make. The website is progressing as we wish to announce our first humorous college football GIF on the site. You have to see Lane Kiffin and Nick Saban, as this is the first of many GIFs to come for everyone's fun. Look for the new one coming out this Thursday spoofing the Arkansas coach for wanting to eliminate the no huddle. Go to the top of the page and click on the tab Humor, GIFs. A midline zone read is when we let the defensive tackle through and zone read him as we're doing here. He's chasing the running back, so the quarterback pulls the ball and runs through the vacated gap. We all saw the long run by Mariota on what appeared to be a zone read, but the sportscasters muffed it in my opinion. Note how we often zone read the defensive end or the light blue circle, and note also how often the linebackers loop outside in what is called a scrape exchange. The defensive tackle crashes down or inside, which is what I believe the Colonels wanted to do, but he got pushed outside into the looping linebacker, or they simply got their signals mixed up. So there was no one to zone read, and we had the big gap because the other linebackers were shooting into the inside zone read gaps, which is what defenses often do to Oregon. I believe it was a busted scrape exchange that turned into the inadvertent midline zone read for a touchdown. Coaches, do let me know your theories on this, as this is my best guess, since we don't plan on having open gaps with no one to zone read. When you're running the traditional outside zone reads as we were in this game, the seal blocks on the outside are crucial, and note how our right tackle is getting out there and blocking the linebacker in space wonderfully. We got big gains from this tackle having the speed and athleticism to make those important blocks, and it was none other than another true freshman in Cameron Hunt. His talents are as advertised. Let me know how you like this video analysis style versus the written text and screenshots of the recent past. Regardless of which form the analysis come in, oh, how we love to learn about our beloved Ducks. I'm Charles Fisher, FishDuck, and to learn more about Oregon football, come to FishDuck.com.